parking accommodations.
Wall Street doesn't count at all.
No.
Wall Street, I'm not quite sure.
No, I'm concerned about the adjacent neighborhoods getting more and more congested because people don't want to pay for a parking garage space. It happens in Fleetwood. There's a garage, nobody likes it. They don't pay for spaces there. They go into the communities.
They park here.
And they do it everywhere.
Yeah, unfortunately, they do here because they're saturated.
You have two rental buildings that don't have enough parking as it is.
Right, can you require it as...
And I'm going to take that, so you're going to turn into, you want to make sure that as part of your review, you have an understanding of the, any fees related to parking, whether it's something that's provided in rent, if it's an additional cost, that essentially what you...
Because a renter doesn't care as much as a condo owner, and they're just going to go park where they can.
Like on my block, people drive, park 3 blocks away from where they live, they park on my block, and...
We've got coming in cabs, we got to park.
I have that too. It's amazing. I have them coming down from Katona, they park there for a week and go on vacation.
Now, one thing I find, because of the municipal parking, you have opportunity for your, not just for your luxury, even for your mixed use, you have valet facilities, but then we're still only talking about 1.5 block, and part of it, and then a covered parking. So into the municipal lot through Sydney. Am I stupid?
No.
So is there a definition of luxury affordable?
There's some more on that, exactly. And how that with your mixed use, which you do with a third, a third, a third.
Luxury affordable.
I think certain things, again, not related to the site plan perspective, I think information about understanding for your review, that point, I don't necessarily want to cover from the sense that the affordability levels are set, they're in the EIS. In terminology, we really look at the percentages as it relates to AMI.
Section 8.
And this one is 80, is this the workplace 85.105?
No.
No, there's no possibility.
What, there was a possibility for towns to fund some projects outside of that community.
Well, and again, the applicant is a variety of subsidies in the area that will happen in some of the county.
So we have more housing than any other community in Westchester.
The mayor
and having more of it is not helping us, it's hurting us.
No, what I'm saying is, which we're going to have it anyway, can we get
maybe,
some
maybe
kind of
not. Maybe, maybe not.
Yeah.
Are there any other pieces of information that the board is looking for?
This is the one. You flip the phases as far as the phase one was luxury. It's no longer luxury or affordable luxury. Market phase three is marketplace, correct? Yeah, phase three is marketplace.
Right.
Jeff.
Yes.
Phase two is Crary Avenue.
Yes, no, I think the question was...
Yeah, we're not counting phase one.
Again, the question is, and I just want to reason for it, that phase one is affordable, phase two is affordable with senior, phase three is market rate. That's a global understanding. There's a lot more detail in terms of percentages of AMI. Again, that's something that...
So phase one is no longer luxury, or as described. 177 units luxury.
Section 8.
14 stories mixed use building with approximately 281,666 square feet.
Section 8.
Luxury is definitely, you know, in terms of having washers and dryers in the community unit and the amenities that are in the building. The affordable function is the capital AMI. So when you have a capital AMI, you have a building that needs a qualification for having all the features that you want in a nice building.
It's acceptable oxymoron.
That works.
Thank you, Commissioner.
Is there a plan B for phase three if, in fact, market rate doesn't materialize and it winds up being a subsidized building?
Well, this is another, with the project, there is another document that would work through this. There's a memorandum of agreement and understanding between the developer and the city because this would be built, a portion of this would be city property. So there's some understanding about the development. The planning board is looking at things from the physical perspective, but there's also a role to play with the city overall in terms of development future phases and any changes to those future phases. So there is an understanding of time in which phases of development will occur. There's an understanding about heights of rental and levels of people that will be occupying certain units. And again, the idea of with the EIS and improving the overall plan, it is that as an overall plan. There's the potential to amend the plan, but it's not amendment of the plan absent any dialogue with the city.
I'm sorry, is that the amendment?
Yes.
Where the building